of it than it is by the time all of this is done. And I think that, you know, Canada are just proving that they're crazy by actually, you know, going through this sort of thing that doesn't need to be gone through with. It's not that we don't have respect for people who are involved with this tour, who have planned this tour, have been waiting for it for a couple of months now. But I think that it's just ridiculous how, you know, we're over-profiling it when it doesn't need to be over-profiled, and we really need to take a step back and realize what we are doing, because there are far more serious things happening in Canada than this happening with the royal family. It's ridiculous. And there will be other events, other milestones they will get to that we'll be able to cover, because, like it or not, Canada is getting just as crazy as the United States. It's getting just as crazy as China and Russia, and eventually we're going to find ourselves in just as worse of a predicament as the United States has found itself in. I mean, they have Donald Trump running for their president of the United States. I mean, out of two candidates you could have chose for to be president of the United States, you have either Donald Trump, and on the other side of the coin, you have Hillary Clinton. I mean, how crazy is that? And every day you're watching GMA, Good Morning America, every day for the last at least 3 weeks, I've been watching Good Morning America, and I've been watching these ridiculous stories about how this guy was shot, that guy was shot, this location was broken into, this location was threatened with a bomb. Recently talking about the New York and New Jersey bombings, which was really ridiculous. They've apprehended the culprit behind that, and thankfully enough, they have dealt with it. We have a very professional police force in New York, New Jersey, and they handled it very professionally, and that really makes us feel safer in the nighttime when we close our eyes and open our eyes up every single morning. But the thing is, I think with how crazy a place like the United States is getting, in places like China and Russia and, of course, ISIS, we all know about that being profiled by CNN.com, who seem not to be able to get enough of this sort of thing. That's where we need to have our resources put aside for. That's what we need to have our resources, like money, put aside for, just in case we come upon a circumstance that we're unable to deal with and we need that kind of money for. And again, you know, it's not that I don't have respect for the royal family, because I do. I respect the hell out of them, because if not for them, a place like the United Kingdom would not exist, and different continents would not exist. World peace would not even be thought of as being possible if not for people like the royal family, because they represent everything that is peaceful and everything that is calm in this world, and everything that actually makes sense in this world seems to revolve around them, because they live this fairy tale kind of life that people dream of one day having. And I really respect the hell out of them. I respect the bejesus out of them for that. I just think this tour has been overprofiled and overkilled and unnecessarily gotten away with. And I think because of everything that's happened recently in the world, especially in this new era that we've come into, I think that we really need to take a step back and really put into perspective what is actually going on here. I just question, you know, should we be using this money for this, or should we be putting this money towards something that is far more beneficial to us as a country? Of course, there are millions of people residing in Canada. I have lived here all of my life, and take it from somebody who actually knows about this and actually has experience having dealt with this sort of thing. We are living in a pretty peaceful country, I'll be honest with you. That's why I've chosen to live here all of my life and why I've been a proud citizen of Canada. I may not admit to it on this radio show, but I am very proud to be a citizen of Canada, living here all my life. And after having lived here all my life, I know this is a peaceful place, a far more peaceful place than a place like the United States, who is getting out of control all the time, more and more. It's spiraling out of control. All these different continents are contemplating war. People are fearing for their lives if China and Russia ever teamed up. It's the end of civilization, which it is. We don't have to get up day in and day out here in Canada, in a place that's referred to as God's country, and worry about that sort of thing, because we're somewhat secure. We don't give a fuck if Donald Trump builds a wall between the United States and Canada. I mean, let's be honest, we don't give a fuck, because we have our own resources, and we'll use our own resources to benefit ourselves, because places like the United States need us for the resources, and he can't get away with building a wall, and he knows that. But we don't really give a fuck if he does it or not. And the thing is, I think that Canada is just really jumping the gun when they're saying, you know, we're going to put our money down for something like a royal tour, something that doesn't need to happen now and can happen probably 5 through 10 years from now. And I think it's just a ludicrous decision to have made, and a decision that's been made way too early, and reason it needs to really be put into a better perspective and really needs to be put in a better blueprint for everybody to really get a greater understanding and grasp on what's really happening here. I do wish them all the best. On a lighter note, I do wish them all the best with this royal tour, but I also do really appreciate people for raising awareness to what's actually happening here, because it doesn't need to be happening. And I think that it's just crazy when you think about the amount of money that's being put down for this that can be used to benefit us as a country far better than what we have ever been benefited before. And I think that, you know, it's something that is not only happening once and going to be happening once in a lifetime. If this was once in a lifetime, I could understand Canada putting down this kind of money. But when you really think about it, yeah, $1.5 to $2 million may not seem like it goes that far, but it really does when you're talking about all the underprivileged people in the world who are suffering because of this sort of thing and what sort of resources this money can be used for and put down towards. So I think that everybody as a union needs to come together, as a force needs to come together and really realize what's going on here. It's not that we don't respect this for happening, because we do. It's just a matter of just how serious and critical this matter can become. It doesn't seem like it's as critical as what I'm putting it out there of being, but when you really sit back and put it in perspective what's going on here and what's been happening over these last 6 through 8 months, it's really far out there. It's really far-fetched. It doesn't need to be happening, and we as a country really need to set a better example than what we have been over these last 6 through 8 months. I mean, who really cares about something like this? Is probably what you're thinking to yourself, and why waste your show on this topic? But, you know, I think it's an issue that cannot be brought up enough, and until it's brought up, you know, enough to make people actually realize what's happening here, I think the more people jump on the fan wagon that I've somewhat created here this morning, I think it will be better, and I think it would better us as a country all together as one. And I think that it could be used to set a far better example. $1.5 to $2 million could be used to set a far better example than what we have set through at least the last 6 through 8 months. Just to update you, this Royal Canadian Tour will be happening in places like British Columbia and the Yukon, and it's going to cost anywhere from $1.5 to $2 million, probably even more by the time the bills are all filed for it. And I think that it's just way too out there, and that's why I've called it A Royal Canadian Expense, is the headline that I'm going to be throwing up on my YouTube channel and then tweeting out for you on my Twitter at JonathanClark1. Along with this, I know a lot of our news feed has been profiling this about the Royal Canadian Tour. You can get that on my Facebook page and on my Twitter at JonathanClark1, and I will keep you updated on this very critical issue. It doesn't seem like it's critical, but it really is when you think about how crazy the world is actually getting. Best of luck to the royal family on their Canadian tour of places like British Columbia and the Yukon. It's going to be fun for them. Probably not so much fun for us financially, but at least it's something that I'm raising awareness to, and I hope many of you are likewise. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
I think it's so cute, and I think it's so sweet, how you let your friends encourage you to try and talk to me. But let me stop you there, oh, before you speak.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go.
I to the no, no, no.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go.
I to the no, no, no.
First you gonna say you ain't running game, thinking I believe in every word. Call me beautiful, so original, telling me I'm not like other girls. I was in my zone before you came along. Now I'm thinking maybe you should go. Blah blah blah. I be like nah to the ah to the no no no.
All my ladies, listen up. If that boy ain't giving up, lick your lips and swing your hips, girl. All you gotta say.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go.
I to the, no, no, no.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go. Thank you in advance, I don't wanna dance. Nope. I don't need your hands all over me. No, no. If I want a man, then I'ma get a man. But it's never my priority. Hey. I was in my zone before you came along. Don't want you to take this personal. Blah, blah, blah.
I be like nah to the ah to the no, no, no.
All my ladies, listen
my ladies.
Up. If that boy ain't giving up. Lick your lips and swing your hips.
Girl, all you gotta say.
My name is no. My sign is no. My number is no. You need to let it go. You need to let it go. Need to let it go.
I to the I to the no, no, no.
My name is no. My sign is no.
Don't go anywhere. HEW Entertainment Radio will return with the latest news, music, interviews, discussion, and Jonathan Clark next.
When something takes place in the world of professional wrestling, you know where to go. WrestleZone.com. WrestleZone.com. Covering all the latest breaking news daily. Interactive forums where you can chat with thousands of other wrestling fans. Exclusive editorials and audio features by some of today's top wrestling superstars. Exclusive video content, weekly polls, live play-by-play coverage of every WWE and TNA pay-per-view. And now, featuring WrestleZone Radio, live.